back to Mama's channel. Merry Christmas to you in advance. Yeah. Oh my God. It's like a few days countdown to next year. So happy new year to you also in advance. Okay, so we're coming to the end of year 2021, and I'm sure a lot has happened to you. A whole lot of experiences, a whole lot of lessons you must have learned. A whole lot of events, you know, memories that have been created and shared. And yes, definitely, I know in one way or the other, hurtful situations has also happened to you. So guys, this is why I'm going to be talking today about how to handle emotional stress, emotional heartbreaks, and, you know, an emotional heartbreak. Okay, the reason why I chose to discuss about this now is because I understand that a lot of things, like I said, has happened to every one of us. So, guys, I understand that it is not easy at all to go through those hurtful experiences, those hurtful moments when you feel like all is ended, when you feel like it's all over and there's nothing else you can do. I truly understand that. So this is why I'm going to be sharing with you how best to handle these things when they come in, how best to handle emotional heartbreaks. You know, we have lots of reasons. There are lots of reasons why we can have heartbreaks. But this video is going to be actually based on relationship heartbreaks. Okay, guys. First off, I'm going to say it happens to everyone. It happens to everyone. It is not something that is strange. It is not something that can't happen to you. It really can happen to you. So even if you've not been experiencing that, you should still watch this video. All right, so if you're excited already about this video, just give a like to it. And then if you like it to the very end, do not forget to subscribe. Alright guys, so first thing I'm going to be saying here is that you have to take a stand. As simple as it might sound, as cliche as it might sound to you, it is necessary and important that you have to take a stand. That is like the first step to getting over the emotional heartbreak that you feel. Nobody's going to take that decision for you. Nobody's going to take that step, that bold step for you. Yes, okay, it is fine. You went through a terrible heartbreak. The partner who you loved broke your heart, and then you're confused. You think all is ended. You think it is impossible to get through this phase. You know, I just want to encourage you that it is actually very possible, because a lot of people have passed through the stage, are going through the stage, and are coming out of it. So it is very possible for you to actually get over this stage. So you have to take a stand and take a decision for yourself. First off, that you're going to get over it. You're going to get through it, and you're going to become stronger and better. Because you can either choose to take out the lessons from that experience, that breakup experience and the whole relationship, or choose to stay there in the pain, wallow in it, and then keep regretting a whole lot of things, which I really can't say right now. Okay, so you can also either choose to get up, learn from it, you know, wisen up, and then become a better person and move on with your life. So you have to just take a decision. It's very important that you do so. All right, the second thing I'll be talking about, the second thing is that you have to let it out. Okay, this might also sound difficult to some people, and then very, negligible to some people, but it's very important as well. It's very important that we let it out. Let all the emotions that you feel inside of you, because you are human. You are human. You are created with these feelings. You're not a robot. You can't just be controlled. You can't say, okay, I'm going to bottle it up and I'm not going to express it because, No. For real, you should let it out. Just take a deep breath. All right, if you're watching this video and you're actually in these shoes, just take a deep breath. And don't be quick to conclude, okay, she's saying trash. Just take a deep breath and think on it. Let it out. Let it out. Let it out. Okay? Let those feelings out. Don't bottle them in. Don't let them choke you. Because when you bottle them in, I don't know, but you should feel this choking effect within you that, oh my God, I can't breathe. I can't breathe. I can't get out of this. This feeling is messing me up. And it's not going to help to bottle it all up. It is not going to help in any way. In any way, trust me when I say it. So even as a guy, because I know this mostly happens with guys, they feel, I should be more manly. I shouldn't, let out my emotions. I mean, I'm a guy. Men don't cry, stuff like that. It is actually very important that you let out just those tears. You shed tears, yes. It is not stupid to shed a tear over a guy or a girl. It is just the emotions finding expressions. All right, so let that be corrected. All right, so you have to confide in someone. That is the third thing I'm going to be mentioning. You have to confide in someone. If you have a friend that you trust, it would really be good to you. It would really do you good to talk to him or her about the experience, about the whole situation. Yes, like neutrally talk to the person about it. You know, do not put yourself in a situation where you're talking to the person in a biased way. When I mean in a biased way, you are making the person judge only on one side. It would help to get a neutral judgment on that situation, okay? And apart from that, the main reason is that it would help, bring everything to a cool. It would help you if you tell it to someone, if you can voice out, so you don't feel all choked up and feel like, okay, nobody's gonna listen to me, nobody can help me. A problem shared is a problem solved. So don't think, I don't think anyone will understand. There are a lot of people who are in the situation that you are in or that has been there, and they shared with people and that's helped them. So I don't know, but you shouldn't go on with the thought that, okay, nobody can help me, nobody will be able to understand what I'm going through, it is impossible to relate. It is very possible to relate. That is the third step, confide in someone. Yeah, you can also confide in a diary, as funny as it may sound. If you're this kind of an introvert, a very shy person, and you don't trust anybody, fine, I'm not going to pressure you to trust someone. But you can trust a book. At least it would help for the meanwhile, so you actually get someone to talk to, because you need to talk to somebody. The fourth step is that you don't need to rush. Do not rush up your healing process. Or compare your healing process with somebody else that you know is in that situation as you are. Don't rush up your healing process, because you are different, you are unique. You don't need to heal as fast as Mr. A or Mr. B would. You are unique and you're your own self. So don't try to neglect the emotions that are still not expressed, all in the name of, okay, I just want to get over this and I just want to get done with it. And then you just leave out some things that have not even been addressed. You just leave out some emotions and some, things unaddressed. It is very, very necessary that you take your healing process one step at a time. Don't compare yourself with whoever it is. Just do things that would help you heal. That's what you must do. If you want to hasten your healing process, then you have to be intentional about it. All right, so the fifth here is that try not to blame yourself. Try not to blame yourself in the fact that I am not saying right now, don't get me twisted, because I'm not saying don't take responsibilities for your actions. If you did anything wrong in the relationship, or if you were at fault, or whatever it is, what I'm trying to say is that learn from your mistakes rather than dwell on them or dwell in them. Learn, pick those things that you must have, thought wrong, those things you think you did wrongly, and then try to work on them so that you will be much better in the next relationship you'd go in or you might go into. So do not try to stay indoors, try to blame yourself all day and then wallow in regrets. You're not in any way making any effort to get out of that moment, of that emotional trauma. You're not gonna help yourself if you sit there all day blaming yourself. Alright, the 16th is get positively engaged. Get positively engaged. Don't sit there all day just, you know, weeping, crying, and doing nothing. You have to get your mind, because the thoughts that make you feel as bad as you feel are those thoughts that are in your head. So you have to get those thoughts filled up with things, a lot of ideas. Go back to that idea, build on it, work out plans, you know, find something you love to do. If it's writing, if it's singing, compose songs, if it's you know, socialize more. Just do something that would help you, and that would positively is the word here, that would positively help you. Don't stay idle. It's not gonna help your mind at all. Alright, the seventh thing here is that you shouldn't try to isolate for too long. Don't self-isolate. Yes, it's necessary that once you are in a situation and you're in that kind of situation, you know, heartbreak and all, most times people tend to, you know, retreat into their tents to think about it and then to actually, you know, dwell on it. But I'd advise that you don't stay there for too long. If you must, okay, don't stay there for too long. Always just try to get away, just try to go out. Even if you don't want to go out with people, you could just go to your, you know, places that would just, environments that would cool you down, where you could see beautiful scenarios, and where you could, you know, if you could go to cinema, do anything that's not going to make you just isolate yourself in one room crying and refusing to eat and refusing to talk to anybody, because trust me, this doesn't help. So a rundown of all I've said. First I said was take a stand, take a decision to get over it, no matter what it is. It's not easy dating someone for like 6, 5, 3, how many years, and then you guys don't end up together. I know, I understand, but you have to take a decision. You just have to. No one's gonna help you out if you haven't decided to help yourself. It's the truth. Alright, so take a decision, let it all out. Don't rush your healing process or compare your healing process with anybody else. Alright, so try not to blame yourself. Try not to blame yourself at all. Get positively engaged and then don't isolate for too long. Don't self-isolate for too long. So guys, if you watched this video to the end, I hope you liked it and I hope you learned a lot from it. Alright, so guys, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. This is Mama's Vlog, where we talk about relationship, have chit chats about it, Q&A, and whatnot. I am still your girl. Please give a like to this video. And let me hear your comments in the comment section. Let me know what you think about it. And if there's anything else, and if there's anything else you want to share, I'm all ears. Love you guys, and Merry Christmas to you once more in advance. Bye.